Getting Pfizer COVID booster? Expect these side effects, new FDA report shows. COVID-19 booster shots will eventually be a common thing to prevent variants from causing more trouble. But how much do we know about their side effects? If you're planning to get one soon, you should know them, especially if you experience them in the initial doses. Keep watching to know the expected adverse events in the latest FDA data. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. Pfizer just submitted new data to the US Food and Drug Administration. The data showed many things about the company's vaccine booster, including adverse events and real-world effectiveness. If you are curious, the data was based on almost 300 volunteers, age 18 to 55, who received Pfizer's vaccine booster shot. In the 53-page document, the frequency of local reactions was similar to the ones reported by volunteers, age 16 to 55, who received the second dose. As usual, the most common side effect was the pain at the injection site at 83%. This was 78% in the initial study by Pfizer on the second shot. Redness and swelling at the injection site were reported as well, at 6% and 8% respectively. What about systemic reactions to the booster? These reactions were similar to those that completed the second dose. Fatigue was the most common at 63.7%, followed by headache at 48.4% and muscle pain at 39.1%. The incidence of these immune-mediated responses, which actually mean that your immune system is doing a good thing but which are unpleasant, wasn't much higher than what we're seeing with a second dose of the vaccine, Kate Mullane, an infectious disease specialist at the University of Chicago, told Very Well Health. However, swollen lymph nodes or lymphadenopathy were more common in those who had a third dose than those who had the first two doses. About 5.2% reported this adverse event after the booster, compared to less than 1% in either the first or second dose. Swollen lymph nodes can be indicators of immune response, though women shouldn't take mammograms after getting the booster. The radiologist may read the exam results inaccurately, so consult with your doctor first. Although these side effects are not that different, it is obvious that boosters may induce adverse events. If you're planning to get that shot, clear your schedule just to be on the safe side. Have you completed the first two doses? What was your experience? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.